and gentlemen, let's welcome to the ring for the main event, Lucha and Booty.
Something like that. Bute, one of the great stars of the past, could give way to a leader Alvarez to greater recognition in this country and worldwide if Alvarez were to win tonight. He's been stuck in the spotlight, stuck in the shadows, excuse me, of guys like Stevenson, of Bute, of David Lemieux, the bigger stars here in Quebec. Win here tonight could erase all of that and give him the big shot that he's been waiting for since he moved to Canada several years ago.
It's interesting, you have two imports, you know, one from Colombia, one from Romania, have both captured the hearts of the fans. I mean, Bute being unique in that regard, probably, as you say, one of the biggest stars in boxing history in Quebec and all of Canada. So Alvarez, now it's his night. This is it. He's got to do it tonight, or really he's going to be relegated to the second tier. Bute's had his career. We're going to see what he has left. Again, the opposition, it's no comparison. 10 or 11 world champs, all the top contenders.
S'affrontent ce soir lors de la finale. Ils sont le parfait exemple d'une intégration réussie à notre société et à nos valeurs. Place à ces deux Québécois qui vont nous donner un grand spectacle. Veuillez s'il vous plaît vous lever pour l'interprétation des trois hymnes nationaux qui les concernent. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the playing of the national anthem.
Thank you. Et d'une présentation de Vidéotron en collaboration avec Mise au jeu.
et se déroule avec l'accord de la Régie des alcools, des courses et des jeux du Québec. Son commissaire de sport de combat, Michel Hamelin, avec l'approbation du Conseil mondial de la boxe, son superviseur, Bob Hill, et sous la surveillance des directeurs, Marc Gagné et Normand Lavoie. Ladies and gentlemen, this championship sanctioned by the World Boxing Council, represented at ringside by Supervisor Bob Galen from Norwich, Connecticut, sponsored by Videotron in association with Visa Jeux. Les officiels, les officials. Chronometreuse timekeeper Laurence Dupuis, chronometreur des chutes, knockdown timekeeper François Dupuis, les juges pour ce combat. Your three judges appointed to ringside to score this championship contest, Richard de Taillefer, Nicolas Esco et Jack Woodburn, tous de Montréal. L'arbitre du combat, Marlon B. Wright. When the bell rings, referee Marlon B. Wright will handle all the action. Et maintenant, en direct du centre Vidéotron, groupe Yvon Michel et Gestev vous présentent le combat principal de ce gala, 12 rounds de boxe pour le championnat éliminatoire des mi-lourds du WBC. And now, live from Vidéotron Center here in beautiful Quebec City, groupe Yvon Michel and Gestev bring you tonight's main event, 12 rounds of action for the WBC Light Heavyweight Championship Elimination. D'abord, dans le poids bleu portant les couleurs du Québec, la culotte blanche et bleue est pesant 173,6 livres. En 36 combats, il a 32 victoires, 25 KO et 1 victoire. Champion du monde IBF des super moyens de 2007 à 2012. Currently ranked 6th by the WBC, he is the former IBF super middleweight champion of the world, Lucien Boutte. Across the ring, his opponent fights out of the red corner. He's wearing blue with white trim. His official weight, 174.6 pounds.
Okay, gentlemen, I gave you my instruction in the dressing room. I want a good, clean fight. Remember, protect yourself at all times. Obey my command at all times. Touch him up. Let's go.
It is time for our main event as we take a look at the tail of the tape. Similar in stature physically, however, Elito Alvarez, 4 years younger. Boutte is substantially more experienced. Vegas odds have Elito Alvarez as much as a 4-1 favorite as round one begins. There are many who have been impressed enough with Boutte's recent performances against Badu Jack and James DeGale, two top flight fighters, impressed enough to think he could pull the upset here tonight. And part of that is because Alvarez has been fairly underwhelming of late. It's not like he's been fighting stiffs, but there are a lot of people who expected that he would stop the likes of Robert Berridge. Tonight, we'll see if he can step up against a true legend in Canadian boxing, Lucien Boutet. Older version of Boutte, let's call it, that we've seen against Jack and Gale, to a lesser extent against Andrea De Luisa, has been an inside fighter, a guy who likes to get in there, throw shots to the body, fight on the inside. Alvarez has been quite the opposite throughout his career. He's a jab artist, throws a lot of jabs, likes to say that he has the best jab in the light heavyweight division.
Well, he can say what he wants. He's going to have to prove that tonight.
Delighted to be here with you for our main event at the Videotron Center in Quebec City. Corey Erdman and Don Majeski here with you ringside. Nothing significant landing thus far. Both men feeling each other out.
Don't hold, don't hold. Let him go.
Tries to whip that trademark left uppercut to the body. One of the problems Alvarez is going to have for a jab-happy fighter like himself as an orthodox fighter is that simply by virtue of fighting a southpaw, often that just gets negated.
Absolutely. You're going to fight hard. It's going to be difficult. It's coming at an angle that you're not generally used to. A fighter with a good left hook and straight right hand has a good chance with a southpaw, but if you're just relying on the jab, it's a disadvantage.
Don't hold, don't hold. Break, break, stop punch, stop punch, back up.
Right hand to the body from Alvarez lands. Tate holds on immediately.
Tate, a couple of left hooks there.
Mostly caught on the gloves of Alvarez. Alvarez fires back, mostly parried by Boutte. It was a good right hand that did sneak through from Alvarez. Tough round to score as the first frame winds down. The crowd certainly reacted better to Boutte's shots, which should come as no surprise. Two begins, a difficult one to score. Certainly a case could be made for either fighter in the opening frame. And that kind of tells the story of Alvarez's career so far. He struggled to set himself apart from the other light heavyweights and from the other stars here in Quebec. In a lot of cases, he's been like the artist who's just waiting for his album to be released. He had an opportunity to face Nathan Cleverley for the WBO light heavyweight title back in 2012. Groupie Von Michel turned it down. They fought Sean Hawk instead. He's been the mandatory for Adonis Stevenson for quite some time. They've now opted to face Lucien Boutte instead, hoping that a win over him would catapult his notoriety just enough to maybe make a little bit more money on that fight.
Absolutely. He needs that breakthrough fight. You can be number one in all the world, but if nobody wants to put up money for the match, I give him credit that he's done that. He's gone against the book, and he said, look, I'm mandatory, have it according to the rules, the regulations, but I got to get the people to want to see this fight. And he took on the biggest name he could find.
There's right hand to the body from Alvarez in that exchange. Ute kind of pushed a left hand that landed as well.
Ute's opening up here. Solid left hook.
Last uppercut, as you mentioned, from Ute. And Alvarez responds, pops the head back. Left jab.
Stop.
Good body work from Alvarez. Marlon B. Wright.
Keep your punches up. Come on.
Go. Say that straight low. Certainly that right hand did. Against Isidro Prieto, Alvarez did seem very comfortable on the inside. Prieto made it very rough, forced him to fight on the inside, mostly for the first time in his career. He did respond well. Good shot from Ute.
Yeah, and this is the hardest puncher Alvarez has ever fought in his life. This man can knock you out with a blow, and so to go in the inside is a big risk there. He's got to, you know, but he's got to make a big impression here tonight, Alvarez. Just can't win. It can't be a controversy in this fight. He's got to show he's the better fighter. I am, as they exchange, I'm just astounded that's 4-1 and 3.5-1 favorite Alvarez. With the record Ute has, I find that very hard to believe. I make this a very close fight either way.
Ute reaches with the left hand. His corner warns him not to do that. Gets there first with a left hand. Both men feeling more comfortable with letting their shots go. And there might be a cut on the forehead of Elito Alvarez. Yes, there is. He's not happy about it whatsoever. We'll take a look.
That would come from a butter cut like that, but we'll have to see the replay and see.
Corner of Mark Ramsey, Vincent Wallet, and Samuel Dicari Drolet. Take a look at that. There is
a cut on the bridge of the nose. Definitely. These guys are going to get roughed up tonight. There's no doubt about it. It's too much at stake for both of them to lay off.
Keep on the punches together. Keep moving the head. La droite au corps, monter le crochet gauche. Et travailler avec le jab. Je veux voir plus le jab de ça, OK?
You're boxing beautiful, fantastic. You're not getting weak, you're moving ahead. It's like in the, it's just like in the gym, you're doing great. Keep the hands up, keep moving there, keep boxing smart. Great stick.
Round three of our main event, which seems to be opening up. Both men cut, good left hand from Ute. Alvarez comes right back with a left hand of his own. Alvarez seems enraged by this cut.
Macy doesn't have time left to waste. He's got those straight right hands to offset that southpaw defense of Ute. And the left hook.
Alvarez talking to Ute in there. Prior to this fight, Alvarez said he was going to be the one to retire Lucian Ute. We're not used to hearing trash talk from Elito Alvarez. He's usually fairly gentlemanly.
Take out the way you want. He's got him on the ropes now. Let's see that finishing him. But he's getting hit back. Getting hit back by Alvarez.
That's a good uppercut from Alvarez a moment ago. Looks for it again. Ute wise to it now. Good counter right hand from Alvarez. That was his bread and butter early on in his career. And he was knocking guys out with it. He's had a bit of a power outage recently in his career. Some of that may have to do with the elbow surgery he underwent about 2 years back.
Blood pouring down the forehead now of Alvarez, and Ute's nose does not seem to be affected by that cut at the bridge when he came out for this round. And one thing Ute has is a killer instinct. When he has you hurt, he knows how to finish you. But Alvarez, good solid right hand.
Yeah. say, Butte is the one getting off first. Alvarez doing some good work to the body, though, in reply.
You know, Alvarez has never lost. Butte's only been knocked out by Carl Froch, one of the most prodigious punchers of all time, one of the great super middleweights in the history of boxing. And Butte really landing solid punches. And we'll see how much of a kite that cut. It rocked him back.
Good shot from Butte. And again, the optics of these punches.
Okay, let's go.
Amplified by the fact the blood continues to stream down the face of Alvarez.
And Butte now has the crowd going, and he's throwing punches and bunches. He's really looking effective here. The blood now coming on Butte's body from Alvarez.
Time!
Vintage Butte to end that round. Can he keep it up for all 12?
Keep sticking him, keep sticking him. And keep busting his fucking head on the inside. You understand? Beautiful. Start digging him through the fucking head. That's the fucking way, my friend. That's it. Beautiful.
See some of the action. Both guys really sitting down in their shots. Four begins what's turning into a very good main event.
Wait, stop, stop. Don't watch that shoulder. Watch that shoulder.
Alvarez trying to shoulder Butte. This is a mean streak from Alvarez that we haven't previously seen.
Well, this could be the frustration of 2 years as the mandatory contender not getting a shot, and this is it for him. He's got to win. He's got to win big, as I said, and Butte right now is winning this bout. So he's got to do everything to come out. And he's trying to knock out Butte, which might be a big mistake, but the way he's got to go, he wants to be spectacular and earn that shot at Stevenson.
Back up. Let's go.
Looking to his corner, obviously, for help right now, Stevenson, which is a little bit amateurish.
Stop.
Perhaps frustrating for Alvarez, who gets warned again for a shot behind the head.
Let's go.
Frustrating that the crowd isn't behind him.
Yeah.
You know, we saw him get a little bit frustrated a couple years back when he fought Andy Gardner. Yeah. When the tables turned, the crowd started to cheer for Gardner. Now Alvarez kind of playing the role of the heel here tonight.
Yeah, and he can't be frustrated by that cut. If he lets that bother him, that's on his mind every second of this fight, he's going to lose. He'll lose concentration and forget what he's in there for. And Butte's just been very good these last 2 years.
Good right hand from Alvarez, comes over the top. Now Butte replies, quick combinations on the inside.
Right in this corner.
Substantially busier than Alvarez right now. Double left hand.
Alvarez coming back, but again, he's got that real power to hurt Butte.
Heavy shots in return. Opens that cut up again on the bridge of Butte's nose. Couple of new Canadians going at it here. One from Romania, one from Colombia. Both have been adopted by the Canadian fan base. For Butte, there was a precedent set with Leonard Doreen, who was also adopted by the Quebec crowd. Another Romanian. For Alvarez, a little bit of a trailblazer. Not too many notable Colombian-Canadian fighters, with the exception of Samuel Vargas, who will return to the ring on March 18th in Brampton.
Few of the South Americans make it north of the American border because there's such a large Latin population in the U.S. to support them. But he's come up here and he's made himself number one contender. Now will he be the fighter to box for the world title? Butte's got the power again. He's definitely dominating in terms of strength.
Heavy shots from Alvarez when he returns fire. Another good left hand from Butte. And another tough round to score.
Boy.
We'll see some of the action. This is quick combinations from Butte. Not necessarily heavy stuff, but again, his volume, and when he gets the openings, when Alvarez has these lapses, it's Butte filling the gaps.
That comes from experience and, again, fighting better fighters. You know, he just is in there. There's nothing that Alvarez will do that'll intimidate Butte. Guy's been with Frock and Pascal and, you know, Badu Jack and all these great fighters, James DeGale. Comes right out with that right hand and then a left hand.
Both guys race out to the center for the beginning of round five. We see our French colleague Bernard Barré, his scorecard dead even through four. And Alvarez, really in every sense of the word, putting all of his cards on the table in this fight. He really has everything to lose. If you lose to Lucien Butte, who realistically hasn't had a significant victory since Glenn Johnson back in 2011, he loses everything.
Absolutely, and he was the mandatory contender, so he could have pushed it through the courts. He would have eventually got his shot. He took a great risk. This almost never happens in boxing. So tremendous credit to him, even for taking this fight, for giving this opportunity to a guy who had vastly more experience, more popular with the crowd. He knows they're going to be on his side.
Well, and he knew how big this was, Don. He spent $25,000 of his purse just on sparring partners.
He went for broke.
Right hand from Alvarez. Chopping right hand as he turns back to the center of the ring.
Oh, good solid two right hands by Alvarez.
Absolutely. Steps inside. Comes down the middle with a right hand.
Butte right back at him. And he sees working the face to get that cut, but I don't know where that cut is. If it's on the far, it's not going to be that damning. But if he can keep opening it up, it's going to be a factor in this match.
Well, it seems to be on the hairline from what we saw when we were zooming in the corner.
That's it. Nice combinations, combos.
You see Butte, if you watch his feet, he is obsessive about getting his right foot on the outside of Alvarez. Alvarez can kind of wane on that front a little bit, but then will step inside with a big right hand.
Oh, he hurt Butte.
Butte goes down.
Whoa. That right hand, chopping right. He is hurt.
I don't think Butte is going to get up from this. Marlon B. Wright. We'll give him an opportunity, but
that's
that is it. Elider Alvarez.
He did it. He earned his shot. He came through. And I got to tell you, you've got remarkable trainers. Mark Ramsey, the Grants, Stefan LaRouche, they're among the greatest trainers. We'll never get enough credit. Phenomenal job by Mark Ramsey. And the Grants as well had Butte going. He was in the fight all the way. But people in Canada underestimate themselves and don't give them the credit. These guys are on the level of any trainers in the world. Freddie Roach, notwithstanding. Wonderful, amazing victory.
We question the power. We question the experience. Elider Alvarez had more than enough of it all.
No, and I question the 3-1 favorite. Now he looked like a 10-1 favorite. I was wrong. The odds makers were right. I would think this is the end of Lucien Butte.
Well, Alvarez said that he would be the one to retire Lucien Butte. Butte insisted this would not be his final fight.
Showed the power. lacking. This earned him a world title fight at Adonis Stevens with an exclamation point, not a question mark.
Is this the last that we will see of Lucien Boutte? If it is, let's take a look at how it ended. Just prior to that, we talked about Alvarez letting Boutte get that position.
Yes.
And then stepping out and throwing the right hand. Watch what happens. Right there, two huge right hands.
And he joins Carl Froch as the only man ever to have stopped Boutte, and that's pretty elite company. And what an ending. And a great, wonderful career. Unless he wants to take an easy fight for a win and go out as a winner, I think Boutte is done. And knowing the kind of character he is, the kind of person, the life he's led, I can't see him going back into the ring.
Boutte has done more than enough for the sport here in Canada if he decides to hang him up after this. But it is Elito Alvarez's time now. Finally, after waiting, after turning down fights, after them being delayed, after injuries, anything that could possibly derail a career and frustrate a fighter, Alvarez has worked through it.
Absolutely, he deserves his title fight. He came through, and he came from the fashion he had to do. Remarkable victory, tremendous win. He and Stevenson, wow, that's a bombs away.
Mesdames et messieurs, le gagnant de ce combat par KO à 2 minutes près de seconde du 5e round.
Improves to 22-0 and